Crippen was a homeopathic physician in New York City when he married Cora Turner, who later took the stage name Belle Elmore in 1892. In contrast to her meek, gentle, diminutive husband, Cora Crippen was intimidating and extravagant. After they moved to London in 1897, she performed as a music hall singer and also had affairs with several other men, while he sold patent medicines. He was aided in his business by a young secretary, Ethel Leneve, who eventually became his mistress. Crippen's wife disappeared in January 1910, the month after telling him she planned to leave him, and to withdraw their savings from the bank. Crippen explained her disappearance to her friends by saying that she had gone on a visit to the United States. Later he published an announcement that she had died there. Meanwhile, Leneve moved into the Crippen house, and accompanied the doctor in public, wearing Cora Crippen's jewelry and furs. Suspicions were raised, and Crippen received a visit from Inspector Walter Dew of Scotland Yard. Crippen told the police that his wife had left him to live with another man. By the time Dew visited the Crippen house a second time, the doctor and his secretary had fled. Dew ordered a thorough search of the house, which led to the discovery of partial human remains in a hole in the basement. An autopsy and forensic analysis identified the remains as those of Cora Crippen, who had been poisoned, then dismembered. In July 1910, Crippen, unaware that his crime had made a sensation in the British press, boarded the SS Montrose to Canada with Leneve, who wore boy's clothes and pretended to be his son. The ship's captain recognized the pair, and notified his superiors via the recently developed technology of wireless telegraphy, marking the first time this technology was used to track a criminal, and riveting the world's attention to the ensuing chase. Dew pursued and overtook the fugitive pair on a faster ship to Canada, where he arrested them. On 25th of October, Ethel Leneve was put on trial as an accessory to murder, and found not guilty. A subsequent appeal on behalf of Crippen was dismissed, and his death sentence was confirmed. On Wednesday, November 23, 1910, 48-year-old Crippen was hanged at Pentonville by John Ellis and William Willis. Crippen's last request had been for a photograph of Ethel, and some of her letters to be buried with him in his unmarked grave. The request was granted.